In this screencast, we're going to look at the different types of code generation available in IntelliJ IDEA and how and when to use them. First, we'll explore some of the common ways to generate code that we've already seen in other videos. Using Command and N on macOS or Alt and Insert on Windows and Linux in the project window, we can create a new package. IntelliJ IDEA will use the full package declaration to create all the necessary folders to match the package name. We can invoke new again with the same keyboard shortcut and use it to create a new Java class. IntelliJ IDEA can create a number of different types of classes, including the new record type. Let's create an interface. IntelliJ IDEA creates a new Java file with the correct code to declare this as a new interface. We can continue creating classes from the project window if we want, but it's often more convenient to do it from inside the code. If we press Alt and Enter on the interface declaration, IntelliJ IDEA suggests an option to implement this interface. We can use the default name suggested, or we can use our own name for the implementation of this interface. IntelliJ IDEA creates a Java class file that implements this interface and opens it in the editor. We can see it's been put into the correct place in the package hierarchy by looking at the project window. So far, we've just explored creating new packages and class files. Let's look at generating new code inside these classes. Using Command and N, or Alt and Insert, again, we can choose to generate a constructor for this class. In this case, IntelliJ IDEA creates a default constructor with no parameters. If we add a parameter into the constructor, we don't have to type all of the code to create a field for this and to assign the parameter to the field. We can press Alt and Enter and have IntelliJ IDEA generate the field in the assignment for us. If we use the Generate shortcut again, we can see the option to create getters for the fields in this class. Let's not do this right now. There's usually more than one way to do things in IntelliJ IDEA. We could also highlight the field by using F2 and show the suggestions for it by pressing Alt and Enter. Here, one of the suggestions is to create a getter for the field. Both times, the only suggestions were for a getter for the field, not a setter and a getter. Let's delete the final keyword, try again, and see what happens. The actions available in IntelliJ IDEA are context sensitive. Now the field can be updated, IntelliJ IDEA also suggests creating a setter for it. If we open the Generate menu, we also see this too has an option to generate a setter. Let's generate a getter and a setter for our number of doors field. IntelliJ IDEA provides a default template for both getter and setter. But for the setter, we could optionally choose to use the builder pattern instead. When we do this, IntelliJ IDEA generates a standard getter and a builder style setter. Let's delete the setter since it's generally better to have a mutable state. Let's look at other ways IntelliJ IDEA can generate code for us. The way IntelliJ IDEA works is it's designed to help us stay in the flow while coding. We often want to sketch out ideas for how we want a class or API to look, rather than manually creating a lot of files up front. IntelliJ IDEA supports this. If we refer to a class that doesn't exist yet, we can use Alt and Enter to get IntelliJ IDEA to create something that makes the code compile. In this case, let's create an enum to represent the fuel type. Let's create it in this package. IntelliJ IDEA creates a valid enum class that matches what our code was expecting, so when we navigate back to our Fiesta class, it's now compiling. We need to assign a value to this field somehow. Using Alt and Enter, we can get IntelliJ IDEA to generate a new parameter on the constructor and assign the parameter value to the field. If we undo this change, we can see an alternative approach. We could use Command and N or Alt and Insert to bring up the Generate menu, and we can choose to generate a new constructor. We can select all existing fields as parameters to this constructor. IntelliJ IDEA will create a second constructor which initializes both fields. Now we've seen that we can generate default or empty constructors, and we could generate constructors from the fields in the class. We also saw at the start that we can alter the signature of a constructor and then have IntelliJ IDEA generate the field and the correct assignment code. We made this a final field, so the editor is warning us that the field is not initialized by all the constructors. We can get IntelliJ IDEA to add a new parameter to the other constructor and assign the value to this field, fixing the warning. Let's delete this constructor in order to keep the code simple. By now, we've seen that IntelliJ IDEA can generate a lot of basic code for us. Let's bring up the Generate menu again to see what else it can do. We can generate an equals and a hashCode method for the class. IntelliJ IDEA has a number of different templates, so we can generate these methods in one of a number of standard styles. We can even see and edit or add these templates, so our code always uses whichever standard we choose. Let's pick this default for this example. We can select which fields to include in the equals method and in the hashCode method. Telling IntelliJ IDEA which fields will never be null simplifies the code it generates. Now we can see standard generated code for equals and hashCode for this class. We can also generate a toString method. Again, we have a number of templates to choose from, and we could define our own. Let's have all the fields appear in toString. Now we have a full domain object with a constructor, getter, toString, equals and hashCode, and we had to do very little typing to create all of this code. IntelliJ IDEA generated most of it for us. Let's go back to our car interface. Let's define a new method on this interface. When we create a method on an interface, we know all the classes that implement this interface should also implement this method. Let's go to the implementation of this interface, the Fiesta class. It doesn't compile anymore, because it doesn't implement the new drive method. We can fix this in a number of ways. We could press Alt and Enter on the error itself, and IntelliJ IDEA will suggest generating the missing method as one way to fix the problem. When we pick this, the correct method is created on this class with a correct signature and sensible defaults to ensure the code compiles. Let's move the method up so we can see it in the context at the top of the class. Let's delete this to see an alternative approach. We could also use Generate and select Implement Methods. Note that the menu shows us there's a shortcut, Control and I, that will take us directly to this feature. This will show us a list of methods on the interface that needs implementing. We only have one method in our case. Let's get IntelliJ IDEA to create it for us. Once the outline of the method is created, it's up to us to implement the details, the actual business logic. We might use live templates here to generate more standard code. We'll see more of this later. We've seen generated methods on the subclass from a signature on the interface, but what about the other way around? We can annotate a method on this class with @override. The IDE will tell us that this is invalid, as there's no method matching this signature on an interface or superclass. Using Alt and Enter on this error provides a suggestion that we can pull this method up to the car interface. Let's do this. The error goes away. The gutter icon shows us this method now implements a method from the car interface. If we navigate to the super method, we can see IntelliJ IDEA generated the method signature on the car interface, which is what we wanted. What else can we generate? We can use the Navigate to Test shortcut from our Fiesta class. Since we don't have a test for this class yet, IntelliJ IDEA offers to create one for us. We can pick from a wide range of different testing frameworks. We're going to pick JUnit 4, since that's the framework we're using in this project. We could generate additional boilerplate like setup and teardown too if this is appropriate. We can use generate again and choose to generate a test method for this class. We should then write the code that tests some aspect of the Fiesta class. Let's generate another test method to show some more ways of getting IntelliJ IDEA to generate code for us. We saw earlier that IntelliJ IDEA is designed to support us while we code, letting us stay in the flow, writing the code the way we think it should look. Code suggestions and completion help where appropriate, yet sometimes we know what we want to write even if it's not supported yet. IntelliJ IDEA provides context-sensitive suggestions with errors like this one, and can generate code that makes our code compile. We want to create a new enum constant for this value in the fuel enumeration. If we look at the fuel class, we can see the petrol constant was declared as expected. Let's put this Fiesta instance into a variable so we can use it. If we're doing test-driven development, we might call methods on an object that don't yet exist. If we do this, we can use Alt and Enter to see what IntelliJ IDEA suggests. We can create a method that matches this signature, and IntelliJ IDEA identifies that we can create it either on the Fiesta class itself or the car interface. Let's create it on Fiesta for simplicity, since we don't know yet if it's needed on the interface. By now, we've covered a whole range of ways IntelliJ IDEA can generate code for us. These are all common use cases that, if we get used to using them while coding, can really decrease the amount of time we spend typing common code, and it frees us up to concentrate on the business problem we're trying to solve. There are more ways to generate code in IntelliJ IDEA. Some are for very specific use cases. For example, we can use the delegation pattern by getting IntelliJ IDEA to generate methods that delegate the call to a delegate inside this class. Now let's put some of these techniques together to show how to use the different types of code generation together to do the heavy lifting of creating code. We can create simple classes that make the code compile as we use them. We can use complete current statement, Command-Shift-Enter or Control-Shift-Enter, to finish off our line and put the caret in the correct place. We can use complete current statement again to create our method's curly braces and get us ready to create the method content. We can even use complete current statement to generate the outline of a for loop, and then we just have to fill in the details, which code completion can help us with. However, that's still quite a lot of typing for a common code pattern. Let's look at an alternative. We can use live templates. There are a number of live templates to iterate over different types of data structures. For a list like this, we can type ITER and press Tab or Enter, and IntelliJ IDEA will create all the code to iterate over our wheels list. Then we could use one of the SOUT templates to print something to standard out. Let's use SOUTV to print the value of wheel.getTireStatus. This method doesn't exist yet because we only just created the wheel class. So let's get IntelliJ IDEA to create it. For now, we'll accept the default implementation and assume we'll get back to it later. We see that by using code generation in this way, the code is compiling almost all of the time. Anytime there's an error, we get the IDE to automatically fix the problem in the simplest way, and we grow our application this way. Thanks for watching.